shot you in here with Peter Queally before, obviously the big...
That's what she said joke, but this guy missed it.
It was fantastic. That's where you found the big box around here. Missing it here.
Squeeze of timing. Where'd you get this guy?
That's what you get when you bring lads up from Kerry. That's the problem here. But there's a lot of Munster lads around here, isn't there? Peter, I suppose it's not that long. I was actually looking at it yesterday. It popped up on my Twitter before your fight was announced. Obviously, the unbelievable comeback against Ryan Scope. We spoke to you directly after and you gave a great interview with talking about the elbow and things. But now, a few months out, how do you reflect on that unbelievable comeback?
Ah, it's just like a dream, to be honest. It was really good fight. I felt like I was dominating. There's a kind of a thing, it was a big back and forth fight. It wasn't too back and forth. It was me dominating the first round, I felt. And then Scope had that unbelievable moment where he just sent that shockwave through my face, basically, and totally turned the fight on its head. And then I came back. But it was just... It's one of those moments in my fighting career that will actually strengthen me. And know, I always knew I was a tough guy, but now I really know I can get through a lot. And just thankful to all the crowd and all the support I get, and to Ryan as well. I was really looking forward to that fight, that he was a fighter that would come in and give the crowd their money's worth. And actually, he comes in to take you out. He's not trying to score points and not trying to grind the clock down and do all these different things. So it was just a perfect storm and a great moment in my career.
Actually, we put up a picture that a couple of weeks ago, and Ryan said, I'll get him in the rematch. Is that something maybe down the line you'd like to have that rematch again?
Yeah, he messaged me asking for a rematch. He messaged me on Instagram. He was like, I want that rematch. And I told him at the time, they'd asked me down to fight Bungard or whatever. They were saying, I was like, I'm fighting him. I said, I'll probably see you down the line or whatever. And I might as well tell you now, it was funny. I was talking to him then, and we just got talking back and forth then. And I said to him then, I said, were you prepared for the crowd, or were you like, whoa, when you came out? And he goes, I thought I was prepared, but I was like, whoa, when I came out. And he said something really funny. He said, as he was making his way into the cage, getting his Vaseline put on or whatever, in his words, there was some wifey standing at the railing screaming in his face, in your head. Like, you can imagine some middle-aged woman now screaming at him. I just thought it was so funny. He said it was just like, holy fuck, what is going on here? But he said he really enjoyed it, and that'll stand to him too going forward. And I believe he's on this card. I'm not sure who's fighting, but I believe he's on this card. So depending on who it is, maybe he'll get a warmer reception now because of the performance he put in, and I'm sure he will.
I suppose my first thought at that time when it happened was like, it's a bit like Cathal Pindred. Yeah. I think even reflecting on it back now, Cathal kind of maybe a few decisions and stuff, and that kind of maybe turned him around in some people's eyes. They thought of him as this unbelievably tough fighter. And you're in this maybe a similar position. Is that something you've since that saw people maybe come more on your side, that, the showstopper nickname, you stopped the show that night?
Anyway. Juice cunt. Finally, it's here now. So, yeah, for sure. It's definitely a moment that like, as John said to me after the fight, he goes, you should be so proud. You lifted 10,000 people. And it's just an amazing feeling. And I felt that when I was leaving the arena. I couldn't even leave the arena. I was staying at the pizza. There was lads patting me on the head and all, grabbing my face and things as I was leaving the arena. I felt like I was the Pope or something walking around. So it was just a really nice feeling to give something back to all those people that, like, give me such mad support. I feel like I'm the most supported in the whole arena on that night. And it's nice to give them a moment back that they'll never forget. And I'm sure they won't forget that.
I suppose coming into this fight, I asked you up there at the press conference, and I suppose maybe with obviously Conor coming back now and Norman Park as well being the champion over in KSW, you're kind of leading the way. And there was obviously rumours a couple of years ago that you would have been signing with the UFC and maybe gone on there. But like, it's taken a long time, hasn't it, for you? I was talking to Kiefer as well, and he said maybe you deserve a little bit. He's only 8 fights in. You've had a lot of tough fights. Is this kind of the culmination of a lot of years of hard work?
Oh, for sure. I've had a long, long road, and a weird kind of a road that not many people took, fighting in all these different places. But I'm glad I took that road, because that's why I'm the one that Bellator are pushing now and are fighting these top guys, because I'm the one who's ready for it. So at the time I often thought about my career and like, oh, I'm doing it wrong. I should have been kind of picking my fights a bit better and stuff. But now it feels right. It feels like I've done everything right, and I'm the one now that can lead this charge and beat these big name American guys.
I was talking to Kiefer there as well, about James. This might be his last time, headlining in Ireland. If he wins, he'll be going on maybe fighting for a title and things. Do you think you're kind of the next guy to come through, maybe headlining the card if James isn't fighting on it?
Ah, for sure. Yeah, I think for sure. Just by our resumes and things, it would make sense that it's me. And then just also by the crowd reaction in the arena, it's pretty obvious, who could main event that show and kind of give that crescendo to the event. But until now, But until that happens, it's so nice to be back to back with James and Kiefer, and we're all kind of like the top three, I feel, on that card, and we're all sharing the load and just kind of inspiring each other, and it's just amazing. I'm just so happy at the moment with this whole Bellator thing and how we're all in it together. We're not all splintered off in different shows, kind of having these different moments. It's a big team effort, it feels like. Just delighted.
You talk about the teams, obviously, that everyone's coming for the 22nd of February, but you also have Conor back in the gym now, obviously fighting a couple of weeks before, and obviously you're in gym with him down in Nice as well. Is that a big thing to have him back in gym, and how is he looking? How's the training going?
Oh, it's unreal. Like, selfishly, I'm just delighted he's back. I don't even care about his fight. I'm just happy, yes, he's back, because I get to train him now again, because he's been a big part of my fight style and my preparation and how I've developed as a fighter is Conor, just because I train him so much. So I'm just delighted he's back and that he's on the mat, and there is an energy he brings to the gym when he's just in the gym training, which we're all feeling again. His fight is so close to our event that it feels like we're all in it together, and it's great. It's amazing to have him back. And he's looking great as well. He's looking fantastic.
That's the thing, I suppose. You know, we don't see him. You know, we can see what he's like. He hasn't fought that much, only once in the last 3 years in MMA. How is he looking in gym? Do you think he's back to... No, I said the Eddie Alvarez fight is one of the best performances I've ever seen. Do you think he's back to that level?
I believe he will be back to that level when he faces Donald. He's like, I see a slightly different kind of, like, he's a bit reinvigorated or something. He's enjoying the training more or something. Maybe he always enjoyed it as much, but I feel like he's more, it's not like, doesn't feel like a camp anymore. He's just kind of in enjoying himself and training, which is what I've seen in his sessions. And that's always a good thing when you're just kind of coming in and you just enjoy training. So I think it will be back to that Eddie, that just sniper. I think he's going to kill Dolan, to be honest. I think it's a kind of a favourable matchup style-wise, and I think he's just going to be on fire as well, on form and ready and back to his old self again.
And I suppose on your fight, fighting Bryn Primus, that's maybe a name that kind of came out of nowhere for someone like me this morning. It's a big name, though, obviously the former champion of Bellator. Do you think a win in that fight puts you right up there as a, you know, for a championship fight?
100%. And just the circumstances surrounding it makes sense as well. He's the former champion, and not like former champion a long time ago. He's just literally once removed out of it. And Pitbull has been shiting on about this SPG thing versus the Pitbull brothers about a year now or more. So it kind of makes sense that way as well. But I do need Pedro to do me a favour now and get him out of the tournament in March. But I think he will do that. And then it makes sense for him to defend his lightweight belt. And of course, then it makes sense if I get a big win over Brent, that it makes sense then for me to be his first defense on that. So I will be calling him out straight away after it. And then I just need Pedro to get rid of him for me.
With James here talking about the 135-pound belt, Pedro talking about the 145-pound. You talk about how many belts are going to be in SPG? What's the prediction?
I think we could have two belts by the end of 2020. Very easily. Very easily we could have two. I think Pedro is going to win that whole tournament. I really believe he will. Especially, like, Pitbull of all of them is a bad matchup for him. He's just like, he's tiny, he's a striker. Pedro is just like, I think Pedro's going to beat him, and I don't see any of them beating Pedro, and they're all looking past Pedro as well. They kind of just, I don't know why they look past him, but that's why Pitbull picked him, I think. I think he thinks he's an easy one or something, but I can tell you now, he's not. And then I think I will be Pitbull as well. I think we could have two belts at least. And James, then, when he gets his chance, he'll get a belt too. And it's just a matter of if he can get it done in 2020, but he will get one.
I was talking to Aaron there, who's been maybe talking about it on the podcast there recently. What's the best gym in the UK and Ireland? And obviously, maybe we're biased towards SPG, but you've got Team Renegade coming through and the London Shoe Fighters and all them.
It's one of the Team Renegade, London Shoe, or us, for sure. It's one of them. There's no one even close to that, I don't believe, really. Of course, you know, SPG is. But, you know, but like Team Renegade, I believe, are, if you look at the accomplishments they're having at the moment, you'd have to... And I wouldn't argue with anyone who said they were as well, because how can you? They're doing so well at the moment. And they're a fantastic group of fighters. And they all have a really, like, flamboyant, aggressive fight style, which for me then is someone I like watching it. Do you know what I mean? So, for sure they're up there as well.
And I suppose last thing here. Before the last fight, it was maybe built up, even by me asking you and other people asking you about the walk and coming in, because we saw it in the fight before that, and maybe it was built up a little bit. Do you think you maybe learnt anything from that and with how that fight went to maybe better prepare for maybe the walkout and the fight here?
Yeah, this one I just enjoyed it more. And I didn't really prepare for that, but it just happened that way. I do distinctly remember this one, walking out and just embracing it a bit more and enjoying it a bit more. Whereas in the first time, it was kind of shocking to me. I'd forgotten I had that many fans because I just hadn't fought him in Ireland for such a long time or whatever. But this time I was more prepared for it and I was able to actually enjoy it more. And I'm hoping I'll be able to enjoy it even more now for this time, and that'll help my performance even more again. You always hope this, but who knows, you know what I mean? But this is what we hope.
Peter, really appreciate it. Thanks very much for the time. Thank you.